Thank you for joining us. It's Infowars Nightly News. It is Wednesday, October 26, 2011. Dr. Sherri Tenpenny, in the second half of the transmission, will break down a global push to forcibly inoculate through fraud, saying it's the law, not just little girls with the dangerous Merck Gardasil HPV vaccine, but now little boys. We're going to look at the dropping fertility and pregnancy rate across the world and expose the depopulation agenda that is afoot here. We also are going to look at the emergency alert system now that some of the big national radio hosts are talking about it, where the federal government for the first time is going to commandeer radio and TV stations and break in next month with a FEMA takeover test of the media. Something that Stalin and Hitler would have dreamed of. That is coming up as well. But first, let's get into a lengthy stack of incredible news and information. Well, they claim they've got a tentative deal, but they're trying to keep the details secret from the German parliament, the Greek parliament, and others. But it has now been released that it's around a €1 trillion, that's about $1,300,000,000 rescue fund. And buried in the details in the German debate was that it is the, quote, insurance for German pension funds, or the actual deposits or the insurance on those deposits of the German taxpayers. And they're selling this whole thing like Greece did this. This is derivatives and bad counterfeit investments of private investors being made good at the expense of taxpayers, just like our banker bailout. More than half of that went to Europe as well. There's another report here out of CNBC. Europe zone to quadruple bailout fund, sources are reporting. So over $1 trillion and right at €1 trillion. And of course, it creates a European superstate. Under this deal, the member states waive their rights into this new bank of the world, this global governance situation that the Pope, his council called for 2 days ago. A global government, that's a quote, global government and a world currency, basically controlled by this new bank of the world. So this is financial domination. And I noticed the London Telegraph, they had today a big live feed with what was being debated in the parliaments. And they had the, quote, liberals of Germany. There's a couple parties that represent the liberals saying you're racist if you don't support the banker takeover. And just saying it's racist. So trendies don't want to be racist. They didn't say why it's racist, just racist. Kind of like slit your wrist or you're racist. Jump off a cliff or you're racist. It's just I have hospitality. I don't hate anybody. Let foreign bankers take me over and take my pension fund. They're like, good. You are now a trendy and can be trusted. By the way, you think I'm joking? Give me a document cam shot of this. Folks won't believe it. It was at 1535 Greenwich Mean Time. That's Greenwich Military Time. And it said that the EU is seen to be one of the left versus right domestic politics. Author and left-wing thinker Owen Jones writes a political blog, Labor, lists that as stands, and then he goes into debates in the German parliament. The EU is seen as the perennial obsession of the Tory right-wing fringes, the sort of issue that excites only bigoted, the Daily Mail, reading Little Englanders. So, and again, it goes through here. They're saying it's racist if you don't want to have England absorbed, all these countries, the private bankers that created the crisis. And, of course, you're like, what does that have to do with race? They're like, that's because you're racist. You don't understand. Give mega banks your pension, or you don't like, well, if you're black, you don't like whites, or if you're white, you don't like blacks. Just don't be racist. And the average yuppie craps their pants, literally, and says, I give up all my rights, okay? You don't call me racist. They're like, throw your kid in an oven, or you're racist. Okay, in the oven. Give us government-run social health care, you're racist. Okay, slit wrist, I don't want to be racist. I mean, it is just total mind control programming. Okay, let's move away from the open establishment of world government that's going on right now, because everything's going to be fine here in the United States, right? I mean, we don't have a push towards internet kill switch. Look at this article that we put out today. Paul Watson was smart enough to actually, when Google put out a report today, its openness report, he was smart enough to search under the takedown orders for the federal government, and we broke at prisonplanet.com and infowars.com today that the federal government is now ordering YouTube, Google, and others to take down videos that are critical of the government. Here's the headline from today. Feds order YouTube to remove video for containing government criticism. That's a quote. U.S. authorities, not servants, authorities, bosses, masters, kings, rulers, lords. U.S. authorities hit Google with 70% rise in takedown orders, including videos critical of government. And it turns out we found cases where videos of protests were taken down. Just 2 weeks ago, the Federal Reserve put in a call to pull down one of our videos. YouTube hasn't done it, but sent us an email saying that it was before the YouTube Grand Committee. So there you have it. Government orders YouTube to censor protest videos. Isn't that just special? And, of course, the Senate committee has come out and said, hey, you get that internet kill switch. But now we learn it's a la carte. If it's government pushing censorship, it's okay. But don't worry. Google, which is really a government front, is getting in on the game. Google activates Android kill switch, zaps useless apps, in their words. It turns out it's apps that weren't approved by the Google Mafia that you put on your own phone. You think you go pay for a phone and now you get an app on it. Sorry, it's an NSA Google app and you don't get that. And of course, that means they're surveilling you, which they admit. Now, continuing here, we first broke this news back when we happened to be sent by listeners by an engineer inside. The fact that body scanners have a massive failure rate. They don't detect really anything. That's why they do the pat-downs after. But again, it's all about just massive profits for the company Chertoff works for. He, as the head of Homeland Security, Michael Chertoff, ordered these, and the company he now works for made billions, and then a year later, he's working for them making money. Somebody needs to protest that company, sue that company, whatever the case is. It's incredible. Now, speaking of sources, this next story, after we get off the body scanners, deals with streetlights all over the United States. I remember being sent by listeners in 98 saying, did you see Kay Bailey Hutchinson's pork barrel where she got these big federal grants to put microphones up in Austin? I mean, look, Austin has these all over the city. Most big cities do. But now, more and more companies are getting on the bandwagon where every street light will be controlled by Homeland Security and have loudspeakers to make announcements and boss you around, like the telescreens going in Walmarts and 9,000 other locations, bossing you around to spy on your neighbors. But now, the new development in all of this is that one company was promoting it. Paul Watson wrote a story about it this morning, and they pulled their own video, not wanting you to see it, but people had already copied all over YouTube. But here's a short snippet where they talk about the Homeland Security applications of streetlights that look normal, but are actually grabbing wireless data, recording everybody audio-wise, and videotaping you beyond Big Brother in 1984. What would have Big Brother done with this? Here's a clip.
Available in a variety of architectural styles and accompanied by a robust platform of digital wireless solutions, IntelliStreets also enables a myriad of homeland security features.
Ah, so we're all safer. Kind of like that Homeland Security grant where Homeland Security actually signed off on it and said put it into the trial period for taser bracelets. Homeland Security actually green-lighted, until we wrote about it and it made national news a few years ago, to beta test everyone when you get to the airport. You don't just get your genitals grabbed or put in a microwave oven or have some bossy pot-bellied Nelly that wants to grab your genitals, tell you how great everything is. No, you get to also have them put a taser bracelet on you, so everyone's safe. Again, you're not watching The Outer Limits or Twilight Zone. This ain't the 60s. This is 2011. It's here. It's here, ladies and gentlemen. That was a colloquialism. I know ain't isn't proper English, but we're not into using proper imperial here. We talk how we want. You understand that? Good. I'm glad you do. Now, continuing, there's a big report out at Infowars.com that links to new government admissions that cell phone towers and EMR are damaging the biological systems of birds, insects, and humans. Of course, thousands of studies have been put out by corporations and governments. Back in the 1980s, when they proliferated wireless technology, they knew that in studies with rats who were exposed to it, it increased cancer. And now there's new studies out from a host of different sources reporting that cell phone towers and EMR damage biological systems of birds, insects, and humans. And I talked to people that are involved in farming, people that are involved in the production of insects that are used in other pest control, that insect numbers are way down. But I also remember driving across the country when I was a kid and the whole front of the car was covered with bugs. Now I go on road trips, everybody talks about less birds, less animals, less insects, and less honeybees. That's actually been researched and documented. In the West, everywhere GMO is engaged in and cell phones are prolific, you've got about 60 to 70% less honeybees. So the curse, the death of the earth, is accelerating, and the people doing it by design have got everybody worried about carbon dioxide that plants breathe instead of all these other things that are happening. We're going to cover that more coming up in a moment. Now, I want to get to the emergency alert system because Glenn Beck, who is probably the third largest radio show in the country, reaching about 10 million people a week, he came out and told broadcasters they could be concerned. The full rant is up at Infowars.com in this article that we posted. And we give credit where credit is due. We like to see Beck going in the right direction. Beck talked about, all we know is the government is wired in systems that take over radio and TV at the transmitter site by federal regulations. And he said that they're going to be taking it over, and it's terrible, but we don't know the full story. Well, Beck, we do know the true story. 14 years ago, in 1997, I documented it. We're going to show a clip of that, because I talked to the engineers involved then, both in government and at the radio stations, about the plan. And I documented it again many times since and earlier this year in February. So we're going to play the Glenn Beck clip now. Then we're going to go to clips from a video I shot in February and a film I put out about a year and a half ago, Police State for the Rise of FEMA, because it's a lot worse, Glenn. They've announced they're going to be taking over cell phones and with forced messages, big jumbo Tron screens, even if you don't want to watch TV. You want to go get food at the grocery store. You want to go anywhere. You're going to be bombarded by Homeland Security saying terrorists are under every table, government loves you, take your shots. I mean, this is an insertion into the matrix where we're bombarded by the brainwashing. Let's go to Beck. The blind pig finding an acorn. He's not a blind pig.
Now, I understand that the EAS system is new and exciting and something brought to you by Homeland Security under the George Bush administration. Have a problem with the EAS system. One of the reasons I have a problem with it is because it seizes control of the broadcast frequency. If I don't trip the EAS system, the station is tripped for me. It's automatic. in the middle of my sentence, if the state wants to take control, they just take it.
Well, good job, Glenn. Rachel Maddow criticizing Obama for continuing torture. That's a blind hog finding an acorn. Beck does a lot of good work. That's why he was run out of Fox. So, Beck, we do commend you. And we're flattered that, again, you take all of our research and repackage it. As long as you get it accurate and don't twist it, take it all. I don't need any credit. Knock yourself out. Because my children have no future if we don't defeat these people. So I commend you. Thank you. Because this is really serious. We're going to show you while I talk here the executive order where FEMA claims this authority over communications. But the issue is, he's saying brought to you by Homeland Security, you know, Barack Obama. This was actually set up in 96 with the Telecommunications Act, the same one that said all cell phones have to be tracked by the government and they can dial in and listen to you even when your phone's off. The point is, Bill Clinton comes and goes, Bush comes and goes, Obama comes and goes. They're puppets, okay? Let's just get this straight. And again, they always repeat executive orders. I told you the power came from 96, and the Telecommunications Act actually put it in regulatorily. Bush signed the order to bump it to the next level and expand it. Each president likes to reaffirm it into the next. But this is everything. This is everything to be taken over. This is your cell phones, as we covered earlier, where the apps are taken off, or police hit a button and a special code goes out to all smartphones where they can't record. Including the new Sony camera I bought has the damn receiver to do this. I mean, everything is having, and by the way, the great part about it is you pay for it. You pay under global regulations, aren't even law, to have kill switches put in everything. Yeah, I noticed our printer paper. We can't buy printer paper now that doesn't have a World Wildlife Fund stamp on it, which says that money from that company was paid to them, which is added on to my bill. And the World Wildlife Fund runs around running eugenics operations. They're not here trying to do anything about real environmental issues. You see the genius of this system? They use our money to destroy us. Now let's go to, what's the first clip, Rob? Okay, so first it's my early report from February of this year. And then it goes into from a year and a half ago. And then it goes to me. And then it goes to Police Day 2000. Okay, all right, from over a decade ago. Okay, so by the way, Police Day 2000 also covers the light poles with microphones on them, which I back then though I would even have the documents, the purchase orders in Austin for this. I told the Austin police chief, have we called to get him on yet? He claims he wants to come on now. He confronted the guys downtown. I want to jump on that because he said, Alex, don't have me on. I brought up the things in towers, and he was like, how do you know about that? And then his adjunct started blabbering. He said, shut up. He was like shocked, like I got one that can see. I mean, come on, man. All right. I'm going to stop right there. By the way, I want to say this, and I say this every show now. The crew overdoes it. I mean, this is because they're in here. They see this. They're living this. They're focused on this, not on the nightly football or acting cool. They're seeing everything I see and more. And that's why they always bring too much to the table. I'd rather have too much than too less. Let's go ahead and go to this compilation just so we can point out that we're the people breaking this. We're the people doing the analysis. We know what we're talking about. If you're a new viewer, this is the real world, folks. This is the real deal. And all of you that work in this system and live on this planet, you're being attacked by this. This is high-tech, modern, authoritarian control. And again, outdoes 1984. Here it is.
This is a test of the emergency alert system.
Executive Order 10,995 allows the government to seize and control the communication media.
Our nation is at war against a far-reaching network of violence and hatred. Training camps have been struck, leaders eliminated, plots disrupted. And all those involved in the attempted act of terrorism must know you too will be held to account.
Think about it. 15 years ago, we allowed the federal government to hardwire emergency takeover systems of all major communications and media in the United States. Now the federal government's coming out in the open and admitting what was already in their internal documents, that they're going to begin having federal break-ins over local news.
If this had been an actual alert, this message would contain specific information on the watch or warning being issued.
Well, it's really happening. Bonafide tyranny is coming to our shores. If you look at Egypt, you've witnessed how the government has seized control of the TV and radio stations. But in the United States, the federal government doesn't need to do that, because under changes in FCC regulations over television and radio in 1996, EAS emergency systems are put in at the radio or TV towers. They're also put in at the national and local cable systems, where the federal government puts a box in at the transmission tower where they can flip a switch and shortwave towers nationwide take over those computers and put out an audio signal of whatever message they want. Senator John Rockefeller, goes by Jay Rockefeller, has announced they need to end the internet, that it's bad, and that private companies will have government hubs tied into them to snoop on everyone without warrants and to be able to shut down the web instantly. See, right now the government has to get warrants and go out and seize all the hubs. Here's another one. America's secret police. Intelligence experts warn the proposal to merge two Pentagon intelligence units could create an ominous new agency. And the head of cybersecurity just resigned 3 weeks ago, saying the Pentagon and Homeland Security are taking over the internet and it's a threat to freedom in America. So their own guys quitting, saying this takeover is happening. All the radio and TV in the nation under the emergency alert system in 96 under a federal law and executive order, FEMA is wired into the transmitters themselves and cable to take over all the systems and broadcast anytime they want. Before, the stations would tune to a signal themselves. Now that's out of their hands. All of that's going on. So see, they've got the preachers, they've got the citizens, they've got the military prepared for martial law, and they could remotely listen to you even when the cell phone's off. That's standardized, the cell phones. And all telecommunications companies were given $9 billion total to put in whole floors for the NSA to move into. So the NSA doesn't tap the phone companies. They are the phone companies. Just like FEMA on all radio, TV, cable, you name it, is already in control with hubs at the transmitter site or at the satellite uplink site. The last piece of equipment, this is in my film Police State 2000, by the way. See, I was sitting there talking to the engineer in 1996 at KJFK FM, and he calls me over and goes, look at this, Alex, they're ordering us to do this. Here's all the secret documents. We're not supposed to show this to anybody. And I was sitting there reading it. FEMA takes over through this. Everything you do goes through this system. I mean, that's what you hear when it goes bang, bang, bang. You know, this has been an emergency alert system. That is a federal test tone going via shortwave radio transmitters, dials in and takes control of your radio station. And that's what they say right here. During emergencies, when they're rounding people up and arresting them and shooting people, their job is to keep the media shut down. They don't have to come arrest Alex Jones. They hit one button, the internet shuts off. They hit one button.
If this has been an actual alert, this message would contain specific.
It doesn't matter, though. The transmission has already been sent. And it's when they make their move that it'll be bad for people like me, but the new world order is going down because we saw what you were doing. We planted billions of seeds. And they now are even more panicked and launching all this, and all they're doing is waking more people up. You tyrants always think you're invincible, but I have studied history and I have foreseen your downfall. That's not confidence, ladies and gentlemen. That's my good old boy guts, and they know. You vampires are going to get your ass handed to you. Because there are a lot of us that don't care what happens to us individually as long as you go down with us. And it's that spirit that's rising that will crush you. Period. Bunch of murdering scum. You've already soft-killed most of us, and we know it. I'm dead already. But you are going to be defeated, you and all your servants. You think the public now knows about you hiring Al-Qaeda and using them all over the world. We're waking up the military. You're going to fail. Time is running out. The sands in the hourglass show that your time is short, and you know it. That's why you run around butchering the planet's genetics, murdering the innocent, engaging in crime after crime. But the spirit of righteous indignation will overturn you and smash you. And you can feel it rising, and I can see your fear. All right, we're going to go to break. We're going to come back with Dr. Sherri Tenpenny. We are having the money bomb, which I've hardly promoted, coming up next Thursday, 24-hour transmission. It'll all be free for everybody, not just members at PrisonPlanet.tv and the radio show, all of it, one transmission, one free video feed. I ask you to spread the word about the free video feed. We're going to start it a day before on the show, just so everybody knows about it. And, of course, the audio streams are always there for everybody. We got a lot of special guests and things coming up. You can donate now if you want to InfowarsMoneyBomb.com. It really angers the trolls and the globalists. And I want to thank the trolls. They don't understand all their attacks. Really help us get the word out. Thank you. Thank you to them. Thank you to the servants of evil, because their weapons formed against us have no success. In fact, it only helps us. I mean, if they strike me down, it only helps us. If they leave me alone, it only helps us. You can't stop people that know the truth and see who you are, you little chicken neck, pot-bellied vampires. We're coming for you. It's game over. You understand? Got an army of Van Helsings who know what you spiritually are, and it's over. See the stake? See the silver? Coming for you. Truth is coming for you. We're gonna dig you out of your holes. We're going to turn the lights on. You're not going to hide under the Abbey anymore. You're not going to hide under the church and tell us you're a bunch of good people. We know what you are. We're coming. You understand that? We'll be right back.
Ron Paul, a visionary who predicted the financial crisis, a leader with a plan to solve it. The Paul Plan? Balance the budget. Cut $1 trillion year one. Eliminate 5 federal bureaucracies. End the foreign wars and nation building. Rein in the Federal Reserve. Pay down the debt. Cut taxes to create jobs. Ron Paul, a plan to restore America now.
I'm Ron Paul, and I approve this message.
If you believe in this information and want to support its viral spread, go to the InfoWars store at InfoWars.com. We've got the new G.I. Joe InfoWars t-shirts. We've got the incredible Pro-Pure gravity-fed filters available at InfoWars.com in the store. We've got a new DVD, Sinus Under Attack, the Don't Tread on Me flag. We've got all sorts of different bumper stickers to help spread the rebellion virally. It's all there, wristbands, citizen rule books in every order. Order online at InfoWars.com today. The water filters, the canteens, it's all there, InfoWars.com. Our mission at InfoWars.com is to audit the Fed, abolish the Fed, restore the Constitution, abolish the TSA, restore the Second Amendment, restore the Constitution, restore the Republic. And if you believe in those goals, then it is your free will, responsibility, and honor to spread the word about our operation and to donate to the 2011 Money Bomb. For many years, I tried to basically stay small, make my films, do my radio show, but it grew and grew and grew. Think about how a money bomb that listeners started 4 years ago led to us being able to move into this bigger office. A later money bomb helped us expand into the empty warehouse next door. And in the last year, we have built the TV studios and put the equipment in and are now doing a nightly news show every night at 7 o'clock that we're now beta testing and getting ready for television. Right now, going out to members at PrisonPlanet.tv and then reaching millions as it spills out onto YouTube and other systems. Help us go to the next level. Not reaching 15 million a week, but reaching 30, 40, 50 million a week. Our growth curve is exponential, but we need to hit our afterburners and turbocharge. History is happening now. The war for human liberty against total dehumanization is on now. Join us Thursday, November 3rd at InfoWars.com. We're going to have a 24-hour plus live transmission with guests and interviews starting at 11 a.m. and running into my next radio show the next day. We're going to have a huge lineup of liberty-loving patriots from all over the world joining us. It's going to be amazing. And this money bomb is going to have a lot of new things added to it that's going to make it even more powerful than past years. So please donate at InfoWarsMoneyBomb.com or InfoWars.com/moneybomb, or simply spread the word about the money bomb. Stand with InfoWars.com and my incredible crew and all of our other supporters and help us get the word out even more. The ball is in your court. The rest is up to you. It's InfoWars Money Bomb 2011. November 3rd, it kicks off 11 a.m. Visit the website at InfoWarsMoneyBomb.com. InfoWars.com/Money Bomb. All right, it's the second half of this transmission. Dr. Sherri Tenpenny is coming up here in just a few minutes. Look, I already have seen this in my own life. If I don't feed my kids properly and I give them a bunch of candy, especially high fructose corn syrup, with caffeine on top of it, because they've had sugar before and also stolen some of my wife's coffee, demons, my little angels turn into little goblins. But they've got another big study out, National News reports on it, that inner city children have higher violence rates, blacks, whites, it doesn't matter, and that they are consuming many times more soft drinks with caffeine and all this. I mean, these kids get a thing of popcorn, 5 or 6 Cokes a day, and maybe a hot dog. Of course they're out of control and angry and irritable. You know how irritable I am right now because I only ate once today? I mean, your brain wants sugar. I'm somewhat hypoglycemic. If I get low in sugar, I get mean. I'm a nice guy. Of course, I mean, but when your kids start bouncing off the walls, when they're at public school drinking 3 or 4 Cokes and then they're not even eating lunch, they say put them on Prozac, put them on Speed, put them on Ritalin to burn their brains out. Not, hey, why are they bouncing off the walls? Why are they acting like this? What dyes, red dye and other things that are known to have chemical effects? It turns out most of these processed foods are really just drugs. And the system knows that. It's addictive. What is a drug? It's something that makes you feel one way, but the real reason you do it again is because, I mean, I've gone out drinking before and had a horrible headache the next day, and I drink again to get away rid of the headache. It becomes a hair of the dog scenario. And that's what's happening on that front. Now, I'm going to talk about this with Dr. Sherri Tenpenny. We'll get little Alex off the screen. Bye-bye, my droogie. Have fun with Stanley Kubrick over there. With the fact that in the last 20 years, we've seen a 40-something percent decrease, depending on which statistic you look at. In just the last few years, there's been something like a 15% drop. We've got a lot of different statistics, but overall, it shows that there is a big drop. But also, you can look at other studies, an overall fertility drop in women, period, in the West. And then we've got all these articles. Well, we've shown you the Rockefeller documents from the 60s, where they said they wanted to develop a vaccine they claimed does one thing, but also reduces fertility. They can't have you totally sterile. It'd be too obvious. So they want to incrementally do it. And so they talk about how they're developing it in the early 60s, but the late 60s, and then the 80s, they said, well, we got it. Let's go ahead and roll this out. So we also have the UN caught in India and Africa and other places adding hormones to tetanus shots to sterilize women. The point is, this is the plan. This is what the White House science are talked about, something in food, water, vaccines to sterilize people or reduce it. But then there's the problem of the public not finding out about it. This is the type of issue that we're discussing. And then I did a headline today because I really wanted to get people's attention. At Infowars.com, it took us 5 days to put this video together. It's really well done. It's 15 minutes long. It's really a mini documentary. And it's titled Alien Genetic Takeover, The End of Humanity. And again, we go on to say, no, not aliens from 10 trillion miles away. Alien just means something not of this realm, like an invasive species, like certain types of rabbits were never in Australia, and they went and overran and basically ate the country, the grass down to nothing, and because there was no natural predators to block them. So that's alien species to Australia, or invasive species. Well, forget that. They're taking, in some cases, 100 different insects, fish genes, others, putting it into things. They're making cats be part jellyfish that glow in the dark, fish that are part insect that will extinct the normal fish. They're not really fish. Humans that are part goat. This is alien. I mean, a goat that's part human, or a goat that's part spider, or a pig that's part human, or a crop that's got 20 different species, or corn that grows HIV virus in it, Protegen put that out. All of this is going on, and we're seeing a huge drop in the pregnancy rates in this country. All of this is interconnected. All of this ties together. And we have this history of them radiating children to death, you name it. So depending on how you slice it, we're seeing between a 15 to 40-plus percent decrease in the teen pregnancy rate here in the United States in just the last few decades. And that sounds great to some people. The problem is, if you look at the numbers of overall infertility, it's way up. Not just in women who go get a career first and try to have children when they're 35, 40. No. Infertility clinics all over the United States and the Western world are just overwhelmed with demand as we see cancer increasing, autism increasing, breast cancer skyrocketing thousands of percentage points. The United States is now the number one breast cancer nation in the world per capita, and it's only growing. What's happening? Our environment, from the GMO, the sodium fluoride in the water, the mercury in the shots, our environment is killing us. Our environment is shortening our lifespans. In fact, the overall lifespan has now for the first time dropped since last year here in the United States. They've just got more high-tech systems to try to keep you alive. Something is happening here. And earlier I went over those documents, just a small snapshot of the Rockefeller Foundation documents and others, where they wanted to develop rice to sterilize men. And they wanted to develop vaccines that you're told you're being given a shot for one thing, but a Trojan horse is built into it to sterilize you. But they don't want it to be 100% though. It's a fertility reducer so that it just happens in the background. And it's very hard to trace. We just showed you the articles from the mid-90s in India and Africa where major research firms found that the tetanus shots in the UN program were having this female hormone added to it that was causing spontaneous miscarriages 100% of the time, which had the added soft kill use of making the women sick. We've shown you these documents. And now we're joined by medical doctor Sherri Tenpenny, probably the leading MD out there for now over a decade, exposing the dangers of vaccines. And I wanted to discuss all of this with her because as it comes out, and we've got these articles coming up, that the flu shots really don't protect you from the flu. And as it emerges that it really is causing neurological disorders, as it emerges that Gardasil doesn't really protect you, as it emerges that it's killing people and maiming others, instead the system isn't backing off. They're throwing it in your face and saying, the CDC panel says give it to boys. And they spin it and say, because boys give it to the girls. I heard that on every news channel in the last few days, listening to television on XM, watching it in my hotel room when I was out of town. It was boys are bad. They're the ones doing it. Almost as if, walk the plank. Get out there. It's your responsibility. Just incredible. And joining us is Dr. Sherri Tenpenny to go over this development and several others. But a frightening flight forward, in my view. Doc, why do you think that, I've never seen such a push to force more and more vaccines, but also Gardasil and the hoax of Perry 4 years ago to say it's the law. Fresh off that collapse and becoming a national issue, they're launching even bigger hoaxes now.
The depopulation agenda is becoming more and more apparent. They have to know. I mean, there's no other way to say it. They have to know. I mean, teen pregnancy is down. It's down, you know, it was up from 2005 to 2006. It had increased by 2000 and in that period by 3%. And now they're saying that, you know, the data that we have is from 2009 saying it was the lowest ever. Now, some of it may be that kids are having more abortions. Some of it may be that they are listening to those pregnant mom television shows and things on Skype. But I believe that the polysorbate 80 and the borax and the Gardasil vaccine, which was released in this country in 2006 for little girls, and now, as you said, Alex, we're going to give it to those dirty little boys. If I were going to go to medical school, if I were starting in medical school now and starting all over again, I would specialize in either OB-GYN or in genetics, because I believe that by the time you would get out of medical school and done your residency program and got into practice, that would, given another 5 to 10 years, that the infertility in this country is going to be rampant. And I believe that there's going to be an enormous number of people who are both men and women who are going to have issues with infertility, and nobody's going to say, oh, well, it was that Gardasil vaccine you had when you were 12.
Well, I mean, earlier, we've got Rockefeller Foundation, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, UN statements. The UN's been caught doing this before, and you see a global push with governments going and even giving billions of dollars to countries like Mexico and saying it's free. You know, it cost $500+ here for the three shots to vaccinate every girl and now every boy in Mexico. And they're saying it's going to be forced in Mexico, just like they tried to say it's forced here. I mean, right there shows the fraud of this and the way they don't care. They don't care how many people die in trials. They don't care how many people get warts all over their bodies or autoimmune disorders. And can you speak to now Gardasil HPV vaccine found contaminated with recombinant DNA? They had a firm test it, as you know, a few weeks ago. SaneVax broke this down that it's not exactly what they told us was really, really in there, doctor.
Well, they talk about that the recombinant HPV virus is truly listed by the CDC and by the FDA, has listed it as a known biohazard and biocontaminant. And when you read the package insert from when the Gardasil vaccine first came out, it said that there was no live virus and no recombinant virus that was present in the vaccine at all, which was an absolute lie. And I'm hoping that there's some smart attorney out there who will go after the pharmaceutical industry and take them to task for that. It's just like the report that came out yesterday that it was a 40-year meta-analysis looking back at all of the stories that had ever been done about the in all the research that had ever been done on the flu shot. They said that, well, it really doesn't work in the elderly, and oh, by the way, we don't think it works in anybody else either. That's just one more confirmatory story, Alex, from when the Cochrane collaboration came out with the same data and said the same things in 2005, 2006, and I believe 2009, where they said the same thing. I believe that there is a RICO violation here or something like that. I'm not an attorney.
No, it is organized crime that they send their lobbyists in to not just lobby, but to get into government positions in the revolving door. They know it's a fraud. They know it's tens of billions of dollars a year. And as you just said, you said this a decade ago from the numbers. It's been well known, even the Canadian studies 3 years ago with the H1N1, and I want you to speak to this, they admitted it doubled your chances of getting the regular, seasonal flu if you took the H1N1 and didn't even protect you. And here's the report out of CTV of Canada again. CNN's also been forced to report it since you're mentioning it. I just want to back you up. But they're spinning it. Flu vaccine less effective than once thought, report shows. I actually read through this, and it just admits that it's totally ineffective. As you always said, they're always giving you last year or the year before's flu, never having an effect the next year. But if you add the numbers of how it reduces your own immunity, it's probably actually makes it net worse.
Oh, absolutely. And the thing is that, you know, think about how many dollars are spent every year, Medicare dollars, which is your and my tax dollars, going into the Medicare fund, and that we are injecting the elderly and the big push through all the CVS pharmacies and Walgreens and all these other places and doctor's offices who say that you've got to get your flu shot, and it's all covered by Medicare, which is, what is Medicare? Our tax dollars. So we are forcing injections on seniors that don't work and that could make them very sick and could probably kill some of them. By the CDC's own admission, they say there's between 70 and 80 cases of Guillain-Barré a year, some of which are caused by the flu vaccine. And we know that that costs tens of thousands, probably millions of dollars. If people have Guillain-Barré and they're in the hospital for several weeks to several months until they get off of the respirator and they have to learn to walk and talk all over again.
Let me stop you again. You're being very conservative here. I know two people in the media in Austin who called me and apologized. One of them is Dale Dudley of 93.7 KLBJ here in town. The other doesn't want to be on air, who took the flu shot 3 years ago and their hands and feet went numb. Two people that don't even know each other. They both went to their doctor and was told, you've got mild Guillain-Barré neurological. We're seeing a lot of it with this shot. So we know about 2% of adverse reactions get reported. You're talking about the really Guillain, you know, the hardcore. But narcolepsy. I know three people who got narcolepsy within a month of taking some of these modern shots. And we've talked to Dr. Blaylock, also a medical doctor, brain surgeon, as you know. He's saying it's causing a autoimmune inflammation in the brain. And again, you have the studies for decades of three flu shots over your life, a doubling in chances of Alzheimer's. I mean, look, we knew when they approved Prozac in 81, it was increasing suicides in the trials. In 91. Now, you see the lawyer ads all over TV. They're losing cases with serotonin reuptake inhibitors because the whole time they knew it was doing this. They knew placebo was better for depression. They knew it actually increased it. This is not just about money making. Bayer knowingly shipping out AIDS-tainted blood. This is some type of death cult depopulation agenda. And I covered their documents earlier. I'm sorry I'm ranting, but you've got the floor. Just break it down.
Well, I can't break it down any further than what you just did, and did an excellent job of that, because each one of those elements is a particular truth. How could they be so negligent? They can't. They can't be that negligent. It has to have an element of intent. And I believe that what we're looking at now, I mean, there was a report that came out, I believe it was yesterday, that says that now autism is one in every 110 children. And Alex, I think this is a really important point I want to make to all of your many listeners. For all of you out there that are trying to eat organic, bring up your kids non-vaccinated, and to have them do the best that you possibly can to keep them healthy, this is the world that your children are going to inherit. You parents that are doing a great job of educating yourself and not vaccinating your kids and not giving them drugs and feeding organic and getting them exercise and plenty of vitamin D and all of those good health things, your children are inheriting a world of 1 in 10 of the people around them have autism. They're not going to be able to have a job. Many of them can't speak. Many of them, by the time they get to be teenagers and even adults, will not be potty trained. Where is the money going to come from to handle that? Where is it? So we can never stop trying to educate parents against the horrors and the potential problems that are associated with vaccines. We just can't ever stop doing it, Alex, ever.
Well, you're right. You know, in my life, 20 years has gone by like that. 35 years has gone by like that. 37 years. It seems like yesterday I was a little child. And now I see my children rocketing up, like shooting up like little weeds. And I see it. I mean, I go to stores. I see children. And when I go to a homeschool event with a couple hundred homeschoolers, their eyes have that old sparkle, like old, you know, black and white films. They're awake. They're smart. I go to a public school event. I go to restaurants, even in nicer areas of town. The children look like neurological zombies. I mean, most of them, they are killing us. And we try to eat almost completely organic with our children, except we're on the road. And I'm trying to tell my wife, and she's telling me, we've got to work together to make sure we protect them. Because even if we're going to sometimes be lazy and hurt ourselves, we can't do it. And they have the big Cornucopia Foundation, as you know, came out 2 weeks ago, studied hundreds of cereal makers, just cereal, and found that Kraft and all these big companies have all these other front companies, and it's even more GMO, and then they're saying it's not, and certifying it, and calling it natural, and it's in Whole Foods, it's everywhere, and then these same companies have seed vaults, and now ARC vaults with the DNA of all the animals. They know what they're doing. I mean, I did a video today that's posted at Infowars.com titled Alien Genetic Takeover, The End of Humanity. And I explain it isn't aliens from a trillion miles away. It is alien in the development of this planet. You're a doctor. Please speak to this. Give us your view. To splice animal, plant, DNA, sometimes stack 100 different species of five or six different families together. And then in all the GMO trials in three generations, totally sterile guinea pigs, you know, all of this stuff, addled, autistic type, you know, things. I mean, all the studies are there. And when you realize it, an alien from a trillion miles away couldn't come to this planet and really wreck things more than these biotech, big pharma are doing. And then you find out they're doing it on purpose. I mean, it is unbelievable. Speak to that.
Well, I agree with you. And I think that part of it starts in medical school. I mean, I was just talking to a patient of mine here in the office today, and I was saying that I really believe that when doctors go through medical school now, they go through, you know, they get into their third and fourth years of training. It's all algorithm driven. If not this, then that. Meaning if you have this symptom, you get this test. And if it's positive, you do this. If it's negative, you do this. And it's all algorithm driven. And it's all absolutely as if every single human were over a machine that you have to run them through the exact same way. And I believe when you talk about aliens, you know, it's like the only thing that makes sense sometimes is who's inhabiting the brains of the people who are making these decisions? Who's inhabiting the brains of these doctors who can't even begin to connect the dots, who will kick parents out of their practice who don't want to vaccinate and will absolutely militantly say, you've got to vaccinate, use every vaccine all the time. You know why? Because they're going to get their quarterly bonuses off of it. Whatever happened to the fact, we talk about them, they, as if they are, you know, over there and they don't have anything to do with us, but they're humans. They're human beings. It's neighbors doing this to neighbors. It's humans doing it to humans for the sake of what? Money, commerce, profit. Why is it that we're doing this to each other? I mean, it's really a scary thing. We can talk about the people at the very top, the Bilderbergers and the people who make the decisions, but there's millions of people downstream from that who are the actual instrumentations of administering the vaccines and are writing out the prescriptions for the drugs.
Well, you know, for thousands of years in every culture, they've described political awakenings and revolutions as the public woke up. And now in the 21st century, in the 20th century, the second half of it, televisions, it takes about 45 minutes with the average adult or child. But once you've learned how to suspend disbelief and go into the hypnotized state, a lower brainwave state, it's a fact. And they taught this when I was going to RTF. Then it takes about a minute to switch into it. That's that mind-numbed thing where if I do let my kids watch TV, I can't even shake them out of it. That's why we don't let them watch much of it. And I've talked to sociologists and people, they point out 50 years ago, you'd go around in New York or any other city or town, people were in the street talking, doing things. Parks were always full. Now they're empty, and you look at the high rises of the neighborhoods, it's glowing blue inside as they watch their televisions. So literally, the public is in a trance, and they're always given a cover story. Well, this is why we do this, and the social engineers know exactly what they're doing, and the robber barons made a decision about 130 years ago, and we've shown all the documents in my film Endgame, to set up a world government, start shutting off resources, develop technologies to control populations and reduce population. And they really believe they're doing the right thing. I ran into an animal rights lady when I was on the road. She'd know who I was. I was talking to her, and she was saying, I think not only should we basically make people get rid of their animals because it's bad for the earth and everything, and you know, but we should also make everybody take an implantation so they can't have kids. And I said, tell me more. And she told me about the foundations she works with and the government and how. And sure, if you're looking at all the unwashed masses and everything, and you're thinking that this water park's too crowded or people have too many tattoos or whatever, you know, it's this elitist attitude. But I always tell them, even if you think you're an elitist, did you get the memo about fluoride in the water? Did you get the memo about mercury in the vaccines? Did you get the memo about GMO? And she's like, no, is it bad for me? And I'm like, yeah, you're not going to be the only, you're not going to be sitting up there, honey, running the levers, doing all this, okay? Because it kind of makes you feel like you're on a power trip or something. This is already being done, okay? And then it gets, and I have you on as a guest, but when I get into this subject, it's one of the areas I have a lot of knowledge, so that I want to, you know, to tell the audience what's happening. But just to be brief, and I want your comment on this, and your lengthy comment on it, Doc, because we're running out of time, and I don't want to dominate here. But let's say the Earth's too overpopulated, as the UN is saying right now. It's 7 billion, and it's going to, you know, the double by the end of the next century. Their own actuaries say it's going to plane off at 8.5 billion by 2025, and that's private groups have shown that, too. Do they understand that the Royal Commission and the CIA Memorandum 200 from 49 and then 73, this is declassified, said if we industrialized the third world, they wouldn't have all these kids. But instead, we're going to let them have all these kids while shutting off their resources so they don't develop. So they actually let everybody have kids, get up to this giant number, and then now we're going to try to soft kill their fertility. I mean, it's really not even a plan by these people. It's more like they like to watch the world burn. Now, what's your view on that?
Oh, gosh, I don't know, Alex. I don't know that I have a specific view on that other than to say that, you know, most parents want to do the right thing for their kids. And what you talked about being in a trance from watching a television, it's pretty easy to put people in a trance. The hard part is to try to wake them up. And I think that we're kind of at a race to the finish line. Are we going to race to the point where we get enough people out there, not only in the U.S. and Canada, but all around the world, that are going to wake up and say, I'm mad as hell. I'm not taking it anymore. I'm not taking your vaccines or your drugs. I'm not doing any of that stuff. Or are we going to have them wake up and be take responsibility instead of abdicating their responsibility to another human standing across the room that happens to be in a white coat? Or are the globalists and the elite people going to win out and they're going to get enough of us dumbed down by the fluoride in the water and the Prozac in the water and the GMO foods and the infertility things? I mean, it feels like we're in this race to the finish line. But can we get enough people awake and alert to fight back against a handful of people that seems to be hiding behind the curtains pulling the levers?
What's the latest on other vaccine news? I mean, is all this mad, I'd say tenfold increase in vaccine propaganda conservatively, is this their desperation as they see people waking up? Because that is happening. I mean, I saw studies just earlier this year we covered where the more educated area of the country you're in, even by county, some areas of Northern California were over 75% unvaccinated. And, you know, they're hyping, oh, my God, the whooping cough. It's going to, you know, get us. But notice, it's the most highly educated. And then I do talk to doctors and scientists now who would have been 5 years ago arrogant going, yeah, we got to reduce the population. They don't even know the program, but they would still say, well, it sounds like a good idea. They're now scared when I talk to them and basically buying doomsteads all over the country, including a lot of them outside Austin. In fact, there's an article, I think it was in CNN today, why are middle class people, you know, preparing for the collapse because it's not coming, they say. I mean, so clearly the middle level intelligentsia has woken up. Are you starting to see that?
Oh, absolutely. And I believe that there is a big push. You know, we are absolutely taking the foundational rock out from underneath the entire pharmaceutical industry. I mean, I have said for a long time, Alex, you and I have had these conversations, and I know you say the same thing, that the vaccine industry is the bedrock of the pharmaceutical industry. If the pharmaceutical industry's vision statement, so I understand it, is that every human on the planet, every man, woman, and child will be on a minimum of one, preferably two, daily prescription medications every day for life. What better way to make that a reality than to start with children and giving them the hepatitis B vaccine and the vitamin K vaccine at birth, and then giving them a series of 40 doses of 16 different vaccines by the time those little bodies are 5 years of age. And there's more and more coming down the pike every single year. There are 330 vaccines in the pipeline right now, and many of them are headed towards adolescence. So for many of your listeners who think, well, I really don't have to make those decisions because my kids are older, guess again, you're going to have to make the decision for adolescents. There are dozens of vaccines headed towards adults. And then someday, hopefully, if you're lucky, you'll have grandchildren. I had somebody post on my Facebook page the other day. It was really good. They said, well, just imagine this, that now when your kids are old enough to get married, you're going to say things like, oh, religion, okay, are they going to be a good companion? Are you on the same economic wavelength? What about education? Oh, is the person that you're dating, have they been vaccinated before? They have? Oh, sorry, I don't want my grandchildren to have all those vaccines in them. We worked very hard to raise you to be an unvaccinated person. And we know that genetically that those vaccines pass down by generations. And so we've created a mess here. We've created a mess. And I think that people need to wake up, more and more need to wake up, get participatory. Your children are inheriting a highly vaccinated population that they are going to have to work to support as they get older. And you need to keep telling all of your friends, family members, and neighbors to stop this travesty. More vaccines are not better. It's a 200-year mistake, and it's not too late to stop.
Well, you're right. It's been going on for more than 200 years, and it's really back to the days of alchemy and extremely dangerous. In fact, there's so many articles coming out. I saw a mainstream article admitting that the people that get measles shots, and I've seen a lot of these, but this was conclusive. I don't have it in the stack, but you may have seen it just like a week ago or so, that people that are getting the measles shot are actually getting the measles at a massively increased level than the general population. Doc, what about the numbers that we've seen in so many cases where the vaccine itself is giving the people the disease or the problem? I mean, I've seen it in the news every year where the UN gives people polio vaccines, and it gives it to them and kills them. What's happening there?
Well, we still know, and we've known for a very long time, that as we continue to use the oral polio vaccine in third world countries where they have poor sanitation and poor hygiene, we give these kids these oral polio drops that go underneath their tongue, that go into their stool, that goes out into the water, that goes downstream to the next person who drinks out of the water. They get exposed, and then they contract paralysis, and the paralysis that we have come to call polio. We know that I just read a report yesterday about the shingles vaccine, that they're now saying that if adults get the shingle vaccine, and we know that there's going to be kids that are going to get the chickenpox vaccine, they're going to have side effects from it, but if the adults have had the shingles vaccine, perhaps they can mitigate the side effects from the chickenpox vaccine given to kids. So now we're doing this whole messy thing of vaccinating people to protect other people. We are now creating vaccines because to protect against problems we've caused by vaccines. It is the bedrock of the pharmaceutical industry, Alex. If we pull it out, everything comes down like a house of cards. Why do you think it is that the CDC to this day refuses to do the vaccinated versus unvaccinated kids study? Someday, somewhere, somebody's going to raise enough money independently to do that study on their own. I don't think it's going to take more than maybe a couple million dollars, and we can have it done with an IRB and done through an educational institution, and we can show unequivocally that what you were talking about earlier about going to daycare or going to schools where the kids are unvaccinated, and you look at how healthy they are and how they're bright and inquisitive and they've got good functioning minds versus the dumbed down kids that have no brain power and they look like they've got fog over their eyes and they just can't think, and it's because they've got brain inflammation going on. If we had an epidemic of children that were going blind, that one in 110 kids were now blind, instead of figuring out how to have more seeing eye dogs and how to teach more of these kids Braille, we would be having a absolute runaway campaign to raise money to stop this blindness and figure out why these kids were going blind. But we have an entire generation, an epidemic of kids losing their minds, and we just go, oh well, maybe they need an iPad. And if we have autistic kids using an iPad, maybe they can learn to communicate rather than looking at what the underlying cause is. It's an absolute travesty.
Well, you know what's behind that. The establishment, and I saw this years ago, and then actually have covered in think tank documents, going back to Edward Bernays, they talked about this. They said, if we're doing something that's making the public angry, and there's some epidemic or some social ill, we'll just go form groups to lead the opposition. And it's like the pink campaign. My wife always talks about this. Everybody is, you know, I mean, it's up several thousand percent. We're the number one country in the world for breast cancer. It's epidemic. Young women are getting it. And there's never a discussion about what is causing skyrocketing breast cancer. It's always, yeah, Let's find a cure for breast cancer, which is more radiation, more chemicals, chemo, more cutting. And it's just amazing. I mean, take my grandmother. She got breast cancer like 6 years ago. And they went in. She said, no, you're going to take out the tumor, and that's it, and I'll just die if that's the case. And then they got all angry. She went and got a couple more doctors. They found a doctor that would just take it out, and she's fine. She went and did her own research, found out the type she had was so slow-growing. She comes back 6 years later. There's a little bit there now. It'll take probably 10 years to kill you. She said, hey, I'm almost 90 years old, okay? The great thing is she's still got her mind. And you know, she's a great, you know, grandmother to my children. But the average person, you know, some 30-year-old gets it, and they just go in there and chop both their breasts off. I mean, I know women who are getting their other breast chopped off because they had it in one breast. They're telling them, we just better chop both off right now. I mean, it's so horrible having my wife, my daughters, my mother, all these women I love, and just seeing this happen to them, and men die, and boys, all these other cancers. And they won't ever ask, why is it skyrocketing? No, that's the question you don't ask, because these lobbies want to keep it going forever. They'll just get more power when all the women have breast cancer. And that's what I think you got at. That's the motive here, is that while they're killing us slowly, they can suck everything out of us and have big galas with politicians up there who are eugenicists laughing. I mean, it is such a sick plan. Closing comments on that.
What are we going to do to change it? How are we going to get people involved? What is it going to take to get people out of their chairs and on the phone, on their computers? How much courage can we give people? How can we define what we want and get a burning, passionate desire to go after it, which means that we need to take back responsibility for our health. And those people who stand up there and laugh about these things, they need to be done away with. And that, you know, that means vote them out of office, get somebody else in. I admit I'm a big Ron Paul fan, and I believe that all the things that he does are really great. I believe that we need to be supportive of the local people that really want to make a difference. I think we need to be courageous and not worry about bringing up the vaccine issue and whether or not our best friend gets angry with us. We're here about saving the planet and what's left of the human race. And I think courage That's is right. the most important thing that we can do.
That's right. I mean, this is about, for viewers out there, I'm going to look right at the camera. This is about getting out of your comfort zone. When this whole society stays in its little bubble and the system wants to make that bubble smaller and smaller and smaller, that's control. And my instincts, unfortunately, have always been right. I knew 9 years ago with the Model States Health Emergency Powers Act, when they openly tried to, and I went, this is what we will close with, it's just so important. I knew with the Model Health States Emergency Powers Act, when they openly tried to get all the police and people to take the shots for smallpox and then anthrax so they could, quote, make us do it, admitted, they did this right from 9/11, we were all in fear, the government launched the anthrax attack, that's come out, to have forced inoculation. The police were smart enough to say no. Only 4% out of 100 agreed of the, quote, enforcers. So now I knew with the TSA, it's about them getting their hands on us, them training us. I knew they'd be on the highways. Now they are. And now I've seen articles admitting during biological outbreaks, the TSA will run checkpoints and will make sure that you either take the shot or go to quarantine. So this is going to be their cover, more than even stage terror. And I'm telling you, it's coming. All the movies, all the preparation. I've told you what's coming before it happened because I've got a survival instinct, folks, just like you do if you turn it on. And it's time to get out of the comfort zone because these people aren't playing games. And I'm telling you, this whole Homeland Security grid is nothing but a cleanup crew for billions of dead people. And I'm telling you, it's coming. And they're checkmated right now because they can't launch this right now because their own enforcers and people have heard the truth and are going to ask questions when all this unfolds. You think Hitler was bad, folks? You ain't seen nothing yet from these eugenicists. And I'm warning you right now, you better get your thinking cap on and your game face on and decide, like the doctor just said, which side are you on? Which side are you on, people that work for Big Pharma and others? It's time for whistleblowers. It's time to stand out. It's time to hit the streets. It's time to call into talk radio. It's called to get angry. When that school lies and tells you it's the law, your kid's got to take a shot, you should get angry by the fact that they're consciously defrauding you and lying to you that it's the law to take the shot. Doc, this whole program to get us used to them putting their hands on us, federally funded blood draws now at checkpoints for DUI, they're now admitting that segueing us to forced inoculation.
Well, what else can you say, Alex? It's just people have got to, you know, you've got to decide which, are you going to go along with the crowd? Are you probably going to end up mass inoculated? Maybe, who knows what else? I mean, if they're doing forced blood draws, that means that they've got DNA samples of you anywhere. And at the least invasive of that would be that they could look at your DNA and say, oh, this person's at risk for getting MS down the road. Or
they've been taking blood for 39 years at birth in every industrialized country in a world program. I got secret documents 16 years ago. People didn't believe it. Now for 4 years, Doc, it's admitted. What else don't we know about? What else are these creepy eugenicists doing?
Exactly.
Well, give us your websites. Tell us how people out there who may be skeptical but now understand it's their duty to check. You know, let's just say we're crazy, we're wrong, though we've been proven right hundreds of times over and over again. Let's just say we're wrong. People still have a small chance it could be true. Of course, it's absolutely true and then some. But they at least have a responsibility to go check out the facts.
They do. You do need to have a responsibility to look at the other side and to understand that there are two sides here. And one is, it's a big decision for a lot of people, Alex. And so if you want more information, I would really hope that you'll come to my website, which is drtenpenny.com, D-R-T-E-N like Nancy, P like Paul, E-N-N-Y, drtenpenny.com. There's DVDs there. There's books there. There's free material. I would hope that you would look at our flu DVD. I know that's also available through Infowars, because there's so much information there that we've done all the work. It's the work's already done for you. So all you have to do is just to sit down and look at 12,000 hours worth of information that's been boiled down into maybe 4 or 5 hours and get yourself educated and stand up and say, I now know that there's another side. I know what's going to happen, and I'm not going to let this happen to myself and my family. I'm not. I'm taking a stand. I'm standing up and being courageous, and I'm going to walk across the field, and I'm going to go over there and stand with the people who are refusing to let this happen to myself and my family.
Well, you've just done incredible work, and your dedication is paying off. You're another testament, Dr. Tenpenny, to what we can all do by stepping up and doing whatever we can in our area. Duty is ours. Consequence belongs to God. People say, well, we can't win. It's too big. Whatever. We got in this position by believing we can't win. We will win. We will defeat this tyranny. God bless you, and thanks for spending time with us.
Thank you so much, Alex.
Wow, what an amazing lady. And as she said, her videos and materials are available at Infowars.com if you'd like to support us as well, or her website that was on screen earlier. And we do have the money bomb coming up. It was listener-supported. You know, the globalists have sold us on an idea that the government takes our money and gives it to media outlets and propagandists like NPR and forces us to finance their evil. But then when alternative media asks for support from people that are like-minded and want to spread the truth, it's bad. And I love the fact that I get attacked by people and trolls over these money bombs, which started 4 years ago as a listener idea, because it really shows we're getting under their skin. And it only makes people donate more at InfowarsMoneyBomb.com, so we can continue to grow this operation and resist tyranny. When they see the trolls all over YouTube and all over my site and the people calling for hack attacks and the demonization, people see right through it. You know, here we are saying buy the books, buy the DVDs, be PrisonPlanet.tv subscribers. And if you want to do more, do our once-a-year money bombs. We can hire some more people. I'm already talking about an extra IT person so we can get even more done, maybe two off the money bomb. I went ahead and pulled the trigger to put them in here as a test ahead of time, and I'm sure the money's going to come in because God always provides through great people out there. We're getting more equipment. We're doing more. We're adding more to PrisonPlanet.tv, more to the radio show. We know the place and time in history we are. We know how critical it is, and it the hoax that people shouldn't support alternative media, doctors like Sherri Tenpenny, people like that, it's all imploding. People are like, wait, it's good to have my money taken, or it's good to have NPR beg for money, or it's good to have George Soros, who steals it, you know, through banker bailouts and stuff, and through currency manipulation, he gives money to all these groups that he's finagled. But then it's bad for Alex Jones to say, if you believe in this message, give us money. It is hilarious. And again, it just shows how people out there and the paid trolls and all the rest of them just can't handle the truth. So even if you can't donate to the InfoWars money bomb, spread the word about it. We're going to be broadcasting at least 24 hours starting next Thursday, November 3rd, right through into the next day. We're going to have a bunch of live guests, a bunch of incredible people are going to be there. And I'm going to broadcast marathon through. We're going to have some special surprises coming up as well. That of course, will all be at PrisonPlanet.tv. It's going to be free to everybody, by the way. We're going to have a video box for everybody to be able to watch the money bomb. And it turns out to be about 20% of our operating capital. And I just know we're going to reach our goal of $500,000, which isn't your grandpa or even your daddy's $500,000. It's about, in 1970s money, it's about the equivalent of $75,000. And we're going to be able to get a couple more IT people, equipment, and a lot more. And I'm very, very excited. And people are already giving at InfowarsMoneyBomb.com. You know, we normally launch this about a month before, and generally about one-fifth of the money we're going to get is donated beforehand. And this time it's a fraction of that because, A, we're in a depression. B, we only launched this thing 15 days before. So if you want to go over to InfowarsMoneyBomb.com and donate, that'd be great. Or buy more memberships to PrisonPlanet.tv. It certainly is concerning the system. It certainly has got the establishment really freaking out. Not just because we are here asking for donations and that idea, but that they need to demonize the idea of voting with your dollars, supporting alternative media, buying organic food, homeschooling your children, doing things like that. They always demonize Ron Paul and put out stories about his spending when it's the cleanest spending out there of any statesman. There aren't many statesmen politicians. You know, they always put out after every congressional campaign lies about that. They don't like this idea of people engage in revolution through their money. The globalists want to use the money that they create out of nothing to enslave us, but we can use it right back against them. So, and I want to just say great job to the crew and their dedication. We'll see you back here, Lord willing, 7 o'clock tomorrow for another edition of Infowars Nightly News. I want to thank Dr. Sherri Tenpenny as well. I thank Aaron Dykes for sitting in while I was on the road out in Las Vegas, of all places, because that's where Ventura was for his TV show. I was out there for 3 days. In Sin City. We're going to have some reports on Sin City. Rob, you've downloaded all that video I shot, right? On top of everything, oh, yeah, time's flying, but we ought to try to get that done by Friday or something, just because, you know, all that footage. But I know I've got to voice it. It was just amazing. It was like Gulliver's Travels meets Pilgrim's Progress meets Journey to the Center of the Earth meets The Matrix. I mean, it was bizarre from start to finish, from the time I hit the Austin airport, the time I flew back. It was the most bizarre, I don't know, what's 3 days, 24, 48? I mean, it was incredible, the things we saw and the things that went on there. And I didn't even really talk about it on the radio today, because something this weird, not aided by ayahuasca or shrooms or anything. I mean something this weird from start to finish that's not a Hunter S. Thompson thing. I mean, I've read some of Hunter S. Thompson's books and stuff, and it's pretty wild how he describes the strangeness of reality, how it's stranger than fiction. This blows any Hunter S. Thompson stuff away. I think I may not even tell these stories, because people can't believe this. It was bizarre. I could write a book just on the experiences. Well, as they say, one cannot be told about the Matrix, one must see it. All right, that's it. We'll see you back on the radio tomorrow, 11 a.m., and back here at 7 o'clock. Have a good evening. Our mission at Infowars.com is to audit the Fed, abolish the Fed, restore the Constitution, abolish the TSA, restore the Second Amendment, restore the Constitution, restore the Republic. And if you believe in those goals, then it is your free will, responsibility, and honor to spread the word about our operation and to donate to the 2011 Money Bomb. For many years, I tried to basically stay small, make my films, do my radio show, but it grew and grew and grew. Think about how a money bomb that listeners started 4 years ago led to us being able to move into this bigger office. A later money bomb helped us expand into the empty warehouse next door. And in the last year, we have built the TV studios and put the equipment in and are now doing a nightly news show every night at 7 o'clock that we're now beta testing and getting ready for television. Right now, going out to members at PrisonPlanet.tv and then reaching millions as it spills out onto YouTube and other systems. Help us go to the next level. Not reaching 15 million a week, but reaching 30, 40, 50 million a week. Our growth curve is exponential, but we need to hit our afterburners and turbocharge. History is happening now. The war for human liberty against total dehumanization is on now. Join us Thursday, November 3rd at Infowars.com. We're going to have a 24-hour plus live transmission with guests and interviews starting at 11 a.m. and running into my next radio show the next day. We're going to have a huge lineup of liberty-loving patriots from all over the world joining us. It's going to be amazing. And this money bomb is going to have a lot of new things added to it that's going to make it even more powerful than past years. So please donate at InfowarsMoneyBomb.com or Infowars.com/moneybomb, or simply spread the word about the money bomb. Stand with Infowars.com and my incredible crew and all of our other supporters and help us get the word out even more. The ball is in your court. The rest is up to you. It's Infowars Money Bomb 2011. November 3rd, it kicks off 11 a.m. Visit the website at InfowarsMoneyBomb.com. Infowars.com/moneybomb.